Some dishwashers from GE Appliances can accommodate a third rack, which comes in handy for hard-to-fit items. We'll show you how to install your own in just a few easy steps. Aside from the product contents, you'll need a Phillips head screwdriver to complete this installation. Be sure to read the instructions provided before beginning. First, you will need to remove the upper rack. Pull the upper rack out to full extension. Any cup shelves should be removed prior to rack installation. Then lift the rack so that the front wheels clear the front end hooks on each side rail. Continue to pull the rack out until the rear wheels contact the front end hooks. Then simply lift the rack off the rails. Next, remove the upper rack rails. Remove the rear end cap from the rail by lifting its center cap and pulling the cap back and off. Then pull the rail off the roller mounts. Repeat on the opposite side. Now install the rack mounts by inserting the locating tab onto the tub slot. Then align the mount with the mounting holes. Use your Phillips head screwdriver to secure the mount with the screws provided. Do the same procedure on the opposite side. You will notice that you have two rack rails. One rail is designated for the right side, the other is designated for the left. Make sure you are using the correct rail on the correct side. To avoid confusion, keep in mind that both front end hooks must point upwards. Install the rail by simply sliding onto both rack mount rollers. Once the rail is in place, attach the end cap by snapping it on the back of the rail. Repeat this step with the other rail on the opposite side. Once the rails are installed, fully extend them both. Then tilt the front of the new rack tray upwards and place its rear wheels just behind the front end hooks. Now slide the rack tray onto the rails until the front wheels clear the front end hooks. Now lower the rack tray and push it into the tub. Check to make sure it is properly engaged by rolling it in and out several times. Reinstall the upper rack rails by sliding them back on their mounts so that both wheels are within the rail. Make sure the front end hook is facing up. Then attach the rear end caps to the end of the rail. You should hear it click into place. Do the same procedure on the opposite side. We suggest installing the adjustable upper rack in its lower position to allow more room between the upper rack and the rack tray. To reinstall the upper rack, fully extend the upper rack rails. Tilt the rack so that the rear wheels connect with the rail and the front wheels clear the front end hooks. Then slide it into position. And you're done. Your new rack tray can hold knives, utensils, and even a whole flatware collection. For more information about our products, visit GEAppliances.com and be sure to subscribe to the GE Appliances YouTube channel for the latest updates, recipes, and more.